Hello guys, welcome back to a brand new video. In this video, I will be discussing what I think is going to be the battleground map for the 2024 presidential election. Now, this is not assuming that Trump has served a second term and this is an open election, or that a Democrat is running for their second term. We are just going to be analyzing what I think are going to be the toss-up states that may not have been toss-up states, or states that are no longer toss-up states that used to be toss-up states. Now, we're going to start by filling off these safe states that are going to be safe, as always. These states are all still going to be safe for the Republicans. All of these states along here, Indiana will also be a safe state. South Carolina will also be a safe state. And looking, that puts the Republicans at 125 still safe electoral votes. The Democrats, we feel, I think Oregon will become a safe state. Looking at all the other places here, Hawaii, Illinois, I'm going to go to Vermont, Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Connecticut, New Jersey, Delaware, Maryland, D.C., and New York. That puts the Democrats, as well as Maine's first district, that puts the Democrats at 183 safe electoral votes to the Republicans' 125. Now we're going to analyze these states, all the states that aren't calling blue or red, how they will be trending come the 2024 election. I think the state of Nevada will stay as a pure toss-up state. I think that the Republicans are going to gain the ability to win in this state. They haven't won here for a while. Obama won it both times, and even Hillary won it. It was considered a toss-up state, but it was one of the few toss-up states Hillary Clinton won in the 2016 election. I believe when it comes to the 2024 election, this is going to be a pure toss-up that could even flip to the Republicans. When it comes to Colorado, I think Colorado is going to trend blue. It used to be a pure toss-up state in terms of Senate elections. You have Michael Bennett, for example. Who ran a Senate election here that was very close, and now it is not as close anymore, and I think that it'll be at least by a likely margin for the Democrats by the 2024 election. I think actually that New Mexico is going to stay as a likely state, both New Mexico and Colorado becoming likely states that are almost sure to go for the Democrats unless you have a phenomenal candidate for the Republicans that can attract voters from here. I think if we're going down to the state of Arizona, I think this is going to be a tilt Democrat by now. I think that if you look at the trends, if we go along here, Arizona here, you can see in the 2016 election, with Hillary Clinton being a terribly unpopular candidate, only lost by 3.5%. But if you're looking at Obama in 2012, lost it by 9%. And in 2008, he also lost it by 9. And you see Bush here won it by 10. Bush here won it by 5. So the last time that it went to the blue column was in 1996 with Bill Clinton's reelection campaign. And looking at it now, you can see that it's coming back into play for the Democrats again. It's even in play for the 2020 election. And I think that if we're going to assume that the trends continue in the state, Arizona will become a tilt Democratic state by then. Now, going over the state of Ohio, as you probably saw here, I believe that Ohio is going to become a likely margin. This may be wrong. Maybe it's just that Hillary Clinton is a very unpopular candidate, but it could also be that the trends in Ohio are making it become more like an Indiana, well, after an Indiana became more like a Missouri. And so if you're looking at this here, Donald Trump won it by around 8%. Obama won the state by 3, Obama won the state here by 5, George Bush won the state here by 2, and then it flipped back to Obama winning it by 5. That's a 7-point difference, winning it by less of a margin, only 3%, but he won it by 3% Obama, and then Hillary Clinton lost it by 8%. That's an 11-point shift towards the Republicans. This is partially due to the fact that Donald Trump's policies are aimed at targeting the people in places like Ohio, and also Hillary Clinton was a very corporate candidate who was very unpopular. But come the 2020 election, I think it's going to be an easy state for Donald Trump to win. And the 2024 election, I think it's going to be even easier for the Republicans to win. Going over to the state of Iowa here, actually, first we'll just put in Nebraska second as a lead. I don't think that's going to change too much. Iowa, I think, is also going to become a likely state. It was won by Obama both times but lost by Hillary Clinton. It was considered a Republican seat before the election had even happened. Hillary Clinton had lost most of her hope in the state, and I think that Trump will win it by a larger margin, maybe in the 2020 election. And then when it's the 2024 election comes around, I think that Iowa will be like Ohio, which I said was like Indiana, which is like Missouri, and Ohio will go by likely margin. Now let's go down here to Texas. Sorry. You can see here Donald Trump won the state by 9 points in 2016, but if you go back to 2012, Mitt Romney won it by 16, and in John McCain in 2008, who was not a good election for the Republicans, even won it by 12 then, went to Bush by over 20 points, 23 points, went here over 20 points, went even in 1996 and 1992. You're gonna have to go back a long way. You're gonna see it went to Reagan both times, went to even Reagan against Carter. So if we're going all the way back here to 1976, that was the last time that the state of Texas went to the blue column. The Democrats only won the state by 4 points here in 1976, and if we just go forward here again, we can see that the Republicans maintained very strong leads here, even against popular candidates like Bill Clinton. But if you see here, Obama, who did very well in the elections, did not do well in the state of Texas. And Hillary Clinton here, who was not a very good candidate either, lost the state by 9 points. But as we saw in the 2018 Senate race against an unpopular Ted Cruz, Beto O'Rourke, even in the 2018 midterm elections when the trends hadn't been noticed as much, Beto O'Rourke was able to get the state within 5 points. And I think that come the 2020 election and even the 2024 election, this is going to be a pure toss-up state for either parties. I don't think either parties can get a grasp on this, can get an edge in this. I think this will be a pure toss-up. Going over to the state of Georgia. We can see here in 2016, Hillary, a white candidate, only lost the state by 5 points. In a state that's predominant and has a lot of black people. For Mitt Romney won the state by 8 points, and then John McCain won it by 6 points. Bush also won it by 16 and 12, respectively, even when in 1996, but hasn't gone blue since 1992 with Bill Clinton, who was a candidate from that area, Arkansas, obviously. And Hillary Clinton did a lot better than Barack Obama did. And I think you have to look at that. You have to look at the suburbs of Atlanta, which, as you can see, is right here. The suburbs of Atlanta and other cities in Georgia have enabled Democrats to do better in the state. And I believe that by, you saw in the 2018 election with Stacey Abrams, she was able to get it very close margin. And I think that by 2024, this is going to be a tilt Democratic state. And I think that that's very interesting to see how the trends are so drastic over such a short period of time. Going down to the state of Florida, I think the state of Florida you can't put as a direct toss-up. I think that the Republicans have got a slight edge here. In the state and local elections, the Republicans have dominated for a number of years now. They have the governor and the two senators and the mayors of many cities and the state legislators. So the Republicans dominate, just not in the presidential elections where Obama was able to win twice, but Trump was able to win in 2016, and he's probably going to win the state in 2020. But I think that the Republicans have gained an edge even in the presidential elections, similar to the edge they have in the local elections, state elections, Senate elections, governor elections, whatever. I think that the Republicans have gained an edge from the state of Florida, which will give them the edge in that state by a tilt margin. Going up to North Carolina here, I think North Carolina is going to stay by a lean margin. I don't think this state is going to change too much. It went to Trump by about 5 points against a very unpopular Hillary Clinton, especially in the state of North Carolina. And I think because of that reason, the state is going to go by a lean margin. If we go over here to Virginia, is Virginia in here? Probably not. Yes, here it is. Hillary Clinton won the state by 5 points. Obama won the state by 4 points in 2012 and won it by 6 points in 2008. The fact that Hillary Clinton was able to win the state by 5 points, this was by a likely margin. Leads me to believe that if Hillary Clinton was able to win the state, even though she was an establishment candidate, corporate candidate, whatever you want to call it, I believe that Virginia is going to become a likely state by the 2024 elections. I believe that this is a state that the Democrats will take more of a control over. I think that this is going to be a state that you'll see is going to be go going blue more reliably from now on. Going up here, we'll go through these a bit quickly. I think all these states are going to be toss-ups, not Minnesota and not Michigan. I think Michigan will be a tilt margin towards the Democrats, and Minnesota will be a lean margin. Wisconsin has a Democratic governor, has one Democratic senator. Actually, I'll put this at a tilt margin towards the Democrats, just because of the fact that they're going to probably in 2022 get two senators and a Democratic governor. And I think, as you saw in my last video, that the state is going to go blue in the 2020 elections, as well as the state of sorry, I'm a little bit sick, as well as the state of Michigan. Then Minnesota won't change too much. It'll go by a lean margin, as it did in 2008, 2012, and 2016. I think it'll stay the same in 2020, and it'll probably stay the same in 2024. We said Wisconsin, Michigan, I think that it'll become tilt margins, and the state of Pennsylvania, I believe, will be a toss-up. Going to the state of New Hampshire here, as you can see over here, Hillary Clinton won it by about 0.4%. Barack Obama won the state by 5 points. He won it by 10 here. And even John Kerry won this by 2 points. So as you can see here, there are noticeable trends here, and I think that this is going to make New Hampshire only a tilt Democratic state, which seems kind of outlandish considering that it went to Obama by 10 points in 2008, and even went to John Kerry, who didn't do so well in that election. Going up to Maine at large here, I think that'll stay likely, and the Republicans will be able to retain Maine's second a tilt margin. This puts the Democrats at 279 electoral votes to the Republicans, sorry, 195 electoral votes with 64 toss-up votes, those states being Texas, Nevada, and Pennsylvania. Now, this map, the demographic changes do not look good for Republicans. You could even, if you give Texas, Nevada, Florida, North Carolina, you could even give them Ohio, Iowa, Pennsylvania. This puts them at over 400 electoral votes. But we'll put these states back. If the Republicans are able to win all of these states, they would still have to pick off maybe Wisconsin, Georgia. Georgia would put them over the top here in this situation. But it's going to be an uphill battle for the Republicans come the 2024 election, whether you like it or not. As a Republican, the demographic changes we're seeing in Arizona, Texas, and Georgia are looking worrisome for the Republicans, and I think that everybody has to admit that it is looking like an uphill battle for the Republicans, as I just said. I think that's what the map was looking like. We'll just put these states at lucky margins. But yeah, this video was almost at 13 minutes long, a long video, but I really believe that it was an insightful video, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe as always, and I will see you guys next time.